ReefDVMs coming at you with a review that people have asked for. They've seen my ThermoPro remote food thermometers in my smoking videos in the past, and they've asked how it's been working and how it's been holding up, because some of the ones they're buying in the Home Depot stores are falling apart. So you know what? We said, sure, we'll put a review out on it. We shot it a while ago. We'll pull out some of that old video footage and put it together. We've had this now for well over a year. It's worked absolutely fantastic. We bought ours through Amazon. It's got two probes, which is kind of nice. So I can actually do either two different types of meat in the same smoker, or like if you're, you know, deep frying a bird, you can put one in the oil and one in the bird. It's got a pretty decent range. I would say, give or take, about at least 100 feet. You know, probably could go a little longer if you weren't inside, and the grill being outside. It's got a nice stand and belt clip on the part that actually goes to the thermometers. I do like that. It makes it a little easier to hook it onto things, especially on the grill. Plus, it also keeps it upright if you want to use that as your thermometer. So one of the neat features about this is you don't need the remote to tell the temperature. If you, say, leave the remote on the kitchen, come out and want to flip the meat and realize, oh, shoot, I left the remote on the kitchen. With some units, you can't get the temperature. This one here, the part that hooks into the meat also has a temperature on it. So that's kind of nice. It comes with four cheap batteries. We ended up replacing the batteries after about 6 months, but, you know, that's kind of the way it goes. One thing I also liked about this unit is this nice rubberized coating around it. I mean, I guess it's kind of a plastic, but it's a softer plastic, so it can take some abrasion, can get some grease on it when you're touching it and stuff like that. That's nice too. Directions are pretty simple. It's pre-programmed for like pig and beef and lamb and chicken, but it also has a customization mode in it, so you can kind of set it wherever you want. It's got a nice timer feature, and the screens are backlit. So you can certainly pick them up quite easily at night. As you can see here, the temperature probes are just out of the box and just plugged in, and they're kind of lining up there at 70 degrees, which is a good thing. And then I'm going to take off the protective screens and kind of let these things kind of warm up and, you know, come to life. Once they come to life, I'm going to play around with different modes and settings on them. And then I'm going to take them out and show you when I was using them in the smoker. The ends of these things now, you know, are kind of completely black from using them in the smoker, the thermometer ends. And the cables obviously have been bent around a heck of a lot more than they are on this video. But they've been working great. They haven't had any issue. Oh, see what I mean here? So when you're looking at this one, you can see the temp on it. It flashes between 1 and 2. Obviously the two different sides of the probe, which is nice. And then about a minute later, or maybe even 30 seconds later, it's on the remote. Again, you can program it to whatever temp you want to set it at. You certainly can do each probe and program them differently. And as you can see there, it's got veal too. It's got ground pork, ground chicken. So it's got fish, ham. It's even got oven. I've never used it in the oven, but I suppose that'd be like using it on a smoker, you know. So you can work it that way too if you want to thread it through your door of an oven, or you have an older oven that's got a port for a thermometer gauge. To me, this is one of the better ones on the market to buy. I tried those dial ones that you just stick in the meat with the dial. The problem is if they get full of oil or residue from the smoking, they don't work because you can't read them. I tried the digital ones that you just stick in, you push a button, check the meat. The problem is when you open up the smoker to check the temp, you're losing heat as that happens, and I don't like that. And certainly neither one of those would work really well for deep fat frying. You know, hams and turkeys, which I put videos out before on. So again, this has been my favorite. Certainly welcome to try it out yourselves, folks, called the ThermoPro. Here we are out at the smoker. We're just kind of getting things going. And we're at 165 degrees at the smoker, put the meat in. And I know it's a little hard to read right now because I don't have the backlight on. But I've got it now in the shop. And it's 156 in the meat and 159 in the other tray of meat. And we're headed up to 160. And then as it hits 160 on the one probe, it starts beeping at me, it starts blinking, the lights light up on it. It's telling me that this smoked lamb is just about done, and we need to get our butts out there and take it out of the smoker. I like this, folks. This is a good machine. I'd highly recommend it. Again, if you see it on my videos, you'll see it as the ThermoPro and has two probes. Thank you for watching and liking our video. Please keep subscribing, folks, and we'll put out more videos like this. Thank you.